Okay, so the big decision as far as the class 12 board examinations has been taken. Prime Minister Narendra Modi deciding to cancel the CBSE class 12 board exams. The ICSE council deciding to follow suit and cancel the ISE board exams. And now it depends on what the state boards do, whether they also go ahead and cancel the different state board examinations. Joining me now is Kapil Gupta of neatprep.com. Kapil, the CBSE notification came out yesterday explaining that they would be on the basis of some kind of assessment that they would drop. What do you make about this entire drama that preceded the decision to cancel the examinations?
Sudhir, thank you very much for this opportunity. First of all, I think these are very tough times for the students. Completely unprecedented. I personally never expected that board exams can be cancelled, because in how many colleges admissions happen through JEE or NEET or some kind of a competitive exam? So board exam is the marks that you carry to get an admission in a Stephens, in a Hindu, in LSR, I'm talking about Delhi. So what is going to happen now? It seems unclear. This notification for me is fascinating. And a lot of people considering the new education policy have also questioned the relevance of board exam. So what they are basically saying is, A, they are going to come up with an objective criteria. I hope they come up with this soon rather than making it again a prolonged affair. Whatever it is, they come out with it soon. Jitna jaldi wo bata dete hain ki kis tarah se wo assess karenge, I think that is very important. Aur dusra cheez unhone usme ye bola hai that if someone is not happy with their score, jo unka objective assessment criteria hai, once they apply it, if someone is not happy with it, they will give an opportunity for those students to write the exam at an opportune time. Jab cheeze thodi theek hongi, wo exam kara sakte hain, to aapko exam karne ka opportunity denge. That is a fair thing. I am just amazed. For a lot of students who were expecting to score above 80% in board exam, a lot of students take pride in their board exam scores. I think a lot of them would want to go and write the exam. So 1.5 crore mein se 15-16 lakh log, 15-16 lakh people would want to go and write exams. So all of it is in the air right now. I just hope all of these decisions are now taken quickly. That is my only hope.
Absolutely. I mean, they should be, because yahan par India mein ek to ye aap Qatar mein hai, kind of an attitude has come about anything that involves students. You know, everyone is made to wait for a critical decision. Now the big question is about the entrance examinations of NEET and JEE Mains and subsequently JEE Advanced. NEET ka jahan tak sawal hai, jab maine NTA se baat ki, to I was told that they will decide on the probable dates within a week. So we can expect some kind of
It's not happening in a day or two. You are saying ek hafte se pehle decision nahi aayega. That is too terrible.
So they are saying that within a week they will decide on whether the date of August 1 needs to be pushed further, and also the dates for the JEE Mains, jo April or May ka edition tha, when they can be subsequently held. My sense is that if the health ministry gives some kind of a clearance and says that, okay, this zone would be safe enough, the cases start coming down, then they could look at sometime end of July for the first edition and end of August for the second edition. This is my guess. And probably just like 2020, look at JEE Advanced in the month of September. What do you make NEET? Because NEET ka jo entire application process hai, that's a much more of a prolonged kind of process. What do you think? Will August 1 remain as the date, or will they definitely need to push it further?
See, Sudhir, again, as you said, aapne JEE Mains ka bataya, July end and August end, and JEE Advanced in September. NEET ka prolong nahi hai. If you look at JEE also, they give certain amount of time when the application form comes in before the whole process starts. So typically, before COVID, the application form will come in first week of December. एक महीना वो रिस्पॉन्ड करने के लिए देते थे. नॉट एवरीवन हैज प्रिंटर एट देयर होम, हैव एक्सेस टू इंटरनेट एट देयर होम. पीपल हैव टू कलेक्ट डॉक्यूमेंट्स, 10th 12th का मार्कशीट, ईडब्ल्यूएस का सर्टिफिकेट वगैरह, थंबप्रिंट वगैरह लगाने पड़ते हैं, घर में इंक नहीं होगा. सो देयर आर ऑल काइंड ऑफ लॉजिस्टिक्स इशू. तो दे यूज्ड टू गिव अ मंथ. मुझे नहीं लगता कि उस प्रोसेस को एक मंथ से श्रिंक किया जा सकता है. देन दे गिव 7 days फॉर पीपल टू चेक whether you have, if you have done any mistakes, you can go back in your application and correct it. After that, they have some process of checking the submissions, एंड बेस्ड ऑन दैट दे डिलीवर द एडमिट कार्ड्स. अब एडमिट कार्ड्स काफी टाइम में आते थे इस चीज को करने के बाद. एटलीस्ट 1.5 to 2 months का एडमिट कार्ड होता था. उस प्रोसेस को श्रिंक भी किया जाता है तो टाइम काफी कम बचता है. फिर उसका प्रिंट आउट लिया, देन स्टूडेंट इज गेटिंग रेडी. एंड इन इन माई माइंड एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम टेलिंग अ स्टूडेंट कि आपका 1 August को एग्जाम होगा इज गोइंग टू बी डिस्टिंक्टली अनफेयर, एब्सोल्यूटली अनफेयर, बिकॉज मेंटली आई एम पर्सनली रिकवरिंग फ्रॉम वॉट आई हैव सीन इन लास्ट 45 days विद रिस्पेक्ट टू कोविड. माई वाइफ हैड कोविड, पीपल आई नो इन फैमिलीज पीपल हैव डाइड और एवरीवन हैज सफर्ड फ्रॉम इट. सो इस वाली चीज से एकदम से उठा के इफ यू टेल देम इन 7 weeks देर इज गोइंग टू बी नीट एग्जाम, इट्स गोइंग टू बी टेरिबल. सो इन माई माइंड अ गुड आइडिया वुड बी समटाइम एंड ऑफ सेप्टेम्बर मिडल ऑफ अक्टूबर नीट एग्जाम seems more reasonable to me, but ultimately what I think doesn't make sense. I thought board exams are not going to get cancelled. I was wrong, and ultimately what government decides be what matters.
Right. इस तरह के जिस तरह से ये बोर्ड एग्जाम्स कैंसिल हुए हैं, व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एन इफेक्ट डू यू थिंक इट विल हैव ऑन द साइकी ऑफ अ स्टूडेंट प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर नीट और द जेई एग्जामिनेशन? व्हाट kind of a impact does it have, you think? Ki abhi exam nahi dena, so it's like a major burden off their head, or do you think that would have actually helped them in their course?
So two things. For students who are in class 12, for them it is definitely a burden off their head. They get a sense of advantage with respect to the fact of not worrying about these exams. Jo droppers hain उनके लिए मुझे लगता है कि शायद कंपटीशन बढ़ गया है. मैंने कल एक वीडियो डाला था जिसमें काफी सारे ड्रॉपर्स कह रहे थे कि अरे दिस विल इंक्रीज द कंपटीशन, दिस विल फर्दर पुश अप द कट ऑफ. बट अल्टीमेटली जो ट्वेल्थ वाले स्टूडेंट्स हैं उनको तो फायदा हुआ है. बट अगेन द रियलिटी ऑफ इट इज स्टूडेंट्स आर स्टक एट देयर होम, देयर फ्रेंड सर्किल डजंट एग्जिस्ट, they can't go and freely interact with people. So mental health is a big issue. Are they mentally fit to write an exam? So again, I come to that. Because of this mental issue, how much stress, how much anxiety they have been under, they should give at least 12 to 13 weeks from now rather than conduct the exam on 1st August in 7 weeks.
Okay. In fact, that was a question I wanted to ask, that, you know, the competition is going to be definitely much more tough now because of the cancellation of the board examinations.
Right.
If you have to quantify in terms of a cutoff, would you be able to kind of put a figure to how much more difficult, how much more tough it will become?
So, Sudhir, cutoff is a function of, there are two factors here. Cutoff is a function of what kind of paper is set. Last year's paper was extremely easy, if you will, right? If they set a good quality paper, cutoff is moderated by the quality of paper. The second thing is, cutoff might go high because 70 to 75% of the students who write NEET exam are students who are first attemptees, who are in their class 12th and writing the exam. Since this 12th exam thing is over for them and they are getting at least 7 weeks, I hope 11 to 13 weeks, they would be much more in competition. So that will that should push up the cutoff. But if the paper is reasonable, cutoff might remain at the same place or come down. But if the paper is the same, cutoff from 614 last year might go up to 625, 630. But it significantly depends on what kind of paper NTA gives.
Okay. My final question, what would you tell to the students? Now, from my side, I've been saying that still think of August 1 as your deadline. Accordingly, plan your study schedule. And of course, any extra time that you get beyond the 1st of August is like a bonus time that you get for revision. What would you tell the students how to, one, remain focused and how to kind of plan their preparation between now and whenever the examination takes place?
I just hope NTA comes out with the dates, whatever it is, as soon as possible. You are saying 7 days. You are much well connected in these circles. So I'm going to...
I'm just quoting what was told to me. Now, it depends. You know how the government functions. Correct. So if it goes to the political bosses again, then it may again kind of take much longer.
So what I will tell students is just plan out your things, and the way you plan out is decides on the dates of your mock test and work backwards and get ready for that mock test. So plan, let's assume, let's say 1st August. So around 8 weeks remain, you should target to write around 5 to 6 mock tests and just plan out how you will get ready for those mock tests. Second thing is, don't try too many things. Focus on NCERT related stuff, especially with respect to NEET. They have been very, very cautious since NTA started taking exams in 2019 to not go outside NCERT. So just remain focused on NCERT and don't get worried about what your friends are telling. They have revised so many times. Most of the time people are lying and they end up scaring you. So don't hear, don't get too much into the peer pressure. And finally, I would tell them, no exam is bigger than your health. So just remain peaceful. Life will give enough opportunities. Try your best. If it happens this year, very good. If it doesn't happen this year, heavens are not going to fall. I did not get into IIT in my first attempt. I know people who get into AIIMS 3rd or 4th time. And it is all right. You know, there is a person from Odisha this year who retired from a bank, then gave NEET, and is now pursuing MBBS at age 64, right? So when you wake up, that is the time morning is, jab jaage tab savera. Just don't get the pressure, let the pressure of the exam eat you up, because then you will not be able to prepare at all. So just remain peaceful and plan out your things, that's all.
Life is definitely all about trial and error. We actually learn much more from the mistakes that we make and then actually do much better the next time around. Thank you very much, Kapil. And I do hope the suspense is kind of, you know, over at the earliest as far as the student community is concerned, so that they don't waste more time looking at different channels and focus on their books instead. Thank you very much for joining us here.
Thank you so much, Sudhir.